Welcome everyone to morning prayer on Friday in the third week after Pentecost for the Church of the Atonement in Chicago. Today we are commemorating Basil of Caesarea. And let me read you the bit that our friends of the Brotherhood of St. Gregory have created about Basil. Basil was born about 329 in Caesarea of Cappadocia into a Christian family of wealth and distinction. Educated in classical Hellenism, Basil might have continued in academic life had it not been for the death of a beloved younger brother and the faithful sister Marciano. He was baptized at the age of 28 and ordained as a deacon soon thereafter. Marciano had founded a monastic community at the family home in Annecy. And inspired by her example, Basil made a journey to study the life of the Anchorites in Egypt and elsewhere. In 358, he returned to Cappadocia and founded the first monastery for men at Ibora, assisted by Gregory of Nazianzus. He compiled the longer and shorter rules, which transformed the Anchorites into a disciplined community of prayer and work. These rules became the foundation of all Orthodox Christian monastic discipline. Basil was ordained a priest in 364. During the conflict between Arsians, supported by the Arsian emperor and the Nicene Christian, Basil was elected Bishop of Caesarea, Metropolitan of Cappadocia, and Extract of Pontus. He was relentless in his efforts to restore the faith and the discipline of the clergy and in defense of the Nicene faith. When the Emperor Valens sought to undercut Basil's power by dividing the See of Cappadocia, Basil forced his younger brother Gregory to become the Bishop of Nessa. Basil also argued forcibly for the full divinity of the Holy Spirit. In his treatise on the Holy Spirit, Basil maintained that both the language of the Scripture and the faith of the Church require the same honor, glory, and worship is to be paid to the Spirit as to the Father and to the Son. It was entirely proper, he asserted, to adore God in liturgical prayer, not only with the traditional words, glory be to the Father through the Son in the unity of the Holy Spirit, but also with the formula, glory be to the Father with the Son together with the Holy Spirit. Basil was also concerned about the poor, and when he died, he willed to Caesarea a complete new town built on his estate with housing, a hospital, staff, a church for the poor, a hospice for travelers. And he died at the age of 50 in the year 379. Just 2 years before the Second Ecumenical Council, which affirmed the Nicene faith. And so today we commemorate Basil of Caesarea. Let's take a moment and we will get started. The hour is coming and now is when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and truth, for such the Father seeks to worship him. Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia. And we continue this morning with the Venite. The earth is the Lord's, for he made it. Come, let us adore him. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and raise a loud shout to him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice. The earth is the Lord's, for he made it. Come, let us adore him. And we continue this morning with Psalm 71 and 72. In you, O Lord, have I taken refuge. Let me never be ashamed. In your righteousness, deliver me and set me free. Incline your ear to me and save me. Be my strong rock, a castle to keep me safe. You are my crag and my stronghold. Deliver me, my God, from the hand of the wicked, from the clutches of the evildoer and the oppressor. For you are my hope, O Lord God, my confidence since I was young. I have been sustained by you ever since I was born. From my mother's womb, you have been my strength. My praise shall always be of you. I have been a portent to many, but you are my refuge and my strength. Let my mouth be full of your praise and your glory all day long. Do not cast me off in my old age. Forsake me not when my strength fails. For my enemies are talking against me, and those who lie in wait for my life take counsel together. They say, God has forsaken him. Go after him and seize him, because there is none who will save. O God, be not far from me. Come quickly to help me, O my God. Let those who set themselves against me be put to shame and be disgraced. Let those who seek to do me evil be covered with scorn and reproach. But I shall always wait in patience, and I shall praise you more and more. My mouth shall recount your mighty acts and saving deeds all day long, though I cannot know the number of them. I will begin with the mighty works of the Lord God. I will recall your righteousness, always yours alone. O God, you have taught me since I was young, and to this day I tell of your wonderful works. And now I am old and gray-headed. O God, do not forsake me till I make known your strength to this generation and your power to all who come. Your righteousness, O God, reaches to the heavens. You have done great things. Who is like you, O God? You have showed me great troubles and adversities, but you will restore my life and bring me up again from the deep places of the earth. You strengthen me more and more. You enfold and comfort me. Therefore, I will praise you upon the lyre for your faithfulness, O my God. I will sing to you with the harp, O Holy One of Israel. My lips will sing with joy when I play to you, and so will my soul, which you have redeemed. My tongue will proclaim your righteousness all day long. For they are ashamed and disgraced who sought to do me harm. Psalm 72. Excuse me. Give the king your justice, O God, and your righteousness to the king's son, that he may rule your people righteously and the poor with justice, that the mountains may bring prosperity to the people, and the little hills bring righteousness. He shall defend the needy among the people. He shall rescue the poor and crush the oppressor. He shall live as long as the sun and the moon endure, from one generation to another. He shall come down like rain on the mown field, like showers that water the earth. In his time shall the righteous flourish. There shall be abundance of peace till the moon shall be no more. He shall rule from sea to sea, from the river to the ends of the earth. His foes shall bow down before him. and his enemies lick the dust. The kings of Tarshish and of the Isles shall pay tribute, and the kings of Arabia and Saba offer gifts. All kings shall bow down before him, and all the nations do him service. For he shall deliver the poor whose cries out in distress, and the oppressed who has no helper. He shall have pity on the lowly and poor. He shall preserve the lives of the needy. He shall redeem their lives from oppression and violence, and dear shall their blood be in his sight. Long may he live, and may there be given to him gold from Arabia. May prayers be made for him always, and may they bless him all the day long. May there be abundance of grain on the earth, growing thick even on the hilltops. May its fruit flourish like Lebanon, and its grain like grass upon the earth. May his name remain forever and be established as long as the sun endures. May all the nations bless themselves in him and call him blessed. Blessed be the Lord God, the God of Israel, who alone does wondrous deeds, and blessed be his glorious name forever. And may all the earth be filled with his glory. Amen. Amen. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. This morning's first reading comes from the book of Ecclesiastes in the 11th chapter and 12th. Rejoice, young man, while you are young, and let your heart cheer you in the days of your youth. Follow the inclination of your heart and the desire of your eyes, but know that for all these things God will bring you into judgment. Banish anxiety from your mind and put away pain from your body, for youth and the dawn of life are vanity. Remember your Creator in the days of your youth, before the days of trouble come, and the years draw near when you will say, I have no pleasure in them, before the sun and the light of the moon and the stars that darken and the clouds return with rain, in the day when the guards of the house tremble and the strong men are bent, and the women who grind cease working because they are few, and those who look through the windows see dimly, and when the doors on the street are shut, and the sound of grinding is low, and one rises up at the sound of a bird, and all the daughters of song are brought low. When one is afraid of heights, and terrors are in the road, and the almond trees blossoms, the grasshopper drags itself along, and desire fails, because all must go to their eternal home. And the mourners will go about the streets before the silver cord is snapped, and the golden bowl is broken, and the pitcher is broken at the fountain, and the wheel broken at the cistern. And the dust returns to the earth as it was, and the breath returns to God who gave it. Vanity of vanity, says the teacher, all is vanity. Besides being wise, the teacher also taught the people knowledge, weighing and studying and arranging many proverbs. The teacher sought to find pleasing words, and he wrote words of truth plainly. The saying of these of the wise are like goods, and like nails firmly fixed are the collected sayings that are given by one shepherd. Of anything beyond these, my child, beware. Of making many books, there is no end, and of much studying is a weariness of the flesh. The end of the matter, all has been heard. Fear God and keep his commandments, for that is the whole duty of everyone. For God will bring every deed into judgment, including every secret thing, whether good or evil. Here ends the reading. Our first canticle this morning is Canticle 10, which is the second song of Isaiah. Seek the Lord while he wills to be found. Call upon him when he draws near. Let the wicked forsake their ways and the evil ones their thoughts, and let them return to the Lord, and he will have compassion, and to our God, for he will richly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as rain and snow fall from the heavens and return not again, but water the earth, bringing forth life and giving growth, seed for sowing and bread for eating, so is my word that goes forth from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but it will accomplish that which I have purposed and prosper in that for which I sent it. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. This morning's second reading comes from Paul's letter to the Galatians in the 5th and 6th chapters. If we live by the Spirit, let us also be guided by the Spirit. Let us not become conceited, competing against one another, envying one another. My friends, if anyone is detected in a transgression, you who have received the Spirit should restore such a one in the spirit of gentleness. Take care that you yourselves are not tempted. Bear one another's burdens, and in this way you will fulfill the law of Christ. For if those who are nothing think they are something, they deceive themselves. All must test their own work. Then that work, rather than their neighbor's work, will become a cause for pride. For all must carry their own loads. Those who are taught the word must share in all things with their teacher. Do not be deceived. God is not mocked. For you reap whatever you sow. If you sow to your own flesh, you will reap corruption from the flesh. But if you sow to the Spirit, you will reap eternal life from the Spirit. So let us now grow weary in doing what is right. So let us not grow weary in doing what is right, for we will reap at harvest time if we do not give up. So then, whenever we have an opportunity, let us work for the good of all, and especially for those who of the family of faith. Here ends the reading. This morning's second canticle is Canticle 18, a song to the Lamb. Splendor and honor and kingly power are yours by right, O Lord our God. For you created everything that is, and by your will they were created and had their being. And yours by right, O Lamb that was slain, for with your blood you have redeemed for God from every family, language, people, and nation, the kingdom of priests to serve our God. And so to him who sits upon the throne and to Christ the Lamb, be worship and praise, dominion and splendor forever and evermore. We continue this morning with the Apostles' Creed, followed by the Our Father using the traditional language. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And we continue this morning with Suffrages A. Show us your mercy, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. Clothe your ministers with righteousness. Let your people sing with joy. Give peace, O Lord, in all the world, for only in you can we live in safety. Lord, keep this nation under your care and guide us in the way of justice and truth. Let your way be known upon earth, your saving health among all nations. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and sustain us with your Holy Spirit. Almighty God, who has revealed to your church your eternal being of glorious majesty and perfect love as one God in Trinity of persons, give us grace that, like your Bishop Basil of Caesarea, we may continue steadfastly in the confession of this faith and remain constant in our worship of you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, even ever one God, forever and ever. Amen. Almighty God, whose most dear Son went up not to joy, but first he suffered pain, and entered not into glory before he was crucified, mercifully grant that we, walking in the way of the cross, may find it none other than the way of life and peace, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, by whose Spirit the whole body of your faithful people is governed and sanctified, receive our supplications and prayers which we offer before you for all members of your holy church, that in their vocation and ministry they may truly and devoutly serve you, through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. During this week of June 9th, 2024, we pray for the sick and those in any need or trouble, and for all those who have asked for our prayers. For Dean, Vicky, Brother David Luke, BSG, Rob L., Carol R., Cheryl, Sean, Jonathan, Devon, Killian, Dennis, Mark, former President Carter, King Charles, Princess Kate, Arun, all with COVID-19, Kelly, Brian B., Shelby, Kathy S., Jason, Harry, Tyler, Cecilia, Ron E., William Sr., Jim, Bill, Ashley, all who mourn. For Ken, Deacon, David, Thomas, and Greg, priests. For an end to war and violence, remembering especially the people of Ukraine, Russia, Iran, the Red Sea, Myanmar, and Yemen. For justice and for an end to the violence and division in our neighborhood, city, and nation. For all healthcare workers, especially Joseph Basil, Jackie, Gary, Will, Choi, Erica K., Larry, Corinne, Lee, Carrie, William, Eric, Lisa, Thomas, and Emily, for all families and children in the city and state, and for all expected parents and for all prisoners, for all members of our military services on active duty, especially Celeste and Nate, and Scott serving as security in Iraq, for Paula, our bishop, and Charles, our rector, for Amanda and Dave, our wardens, and for the members of our vestry, and for our sister parishes of St. Benedict and St. Matthew's in Chiapas, Mexico. And this week, we remember the birthdays of Carol Trapp, Father Gary Lawler, Nicholas Chalice, Janine Singleton. And we recall the anniversaries of the diaconal ordination of Father Tom Scott and Father Charles Everson, and the wedding anniversary of Kevin Simcox and Carolyn Neal. And we remember the departed, the Reverend James Lawson Jr., Jurgen Moltmann, retired Apollo 8 astronaut William Anders, Boris Wolfson, and all victims of gun violence. At the anniversaries of their death, we remember Stephen Pate, Nagin Chorlu, Linda Sikia, Florence Starr, Alessandra Norman Armanda, Denver Charles Davis, Robert Barman, the 49 people killed in the Pulse nightclub shooting in Florida, Orlando. Brent and Marcia Cameroon. David Blonde, John Jensen, Eleanor Dahmer, and John Tolman. And we pray for peace. Lord God of Abraham, God of the prophets, God of love, you created us and you call us to live as brothers and sisters. Give us the strength daily to be instruments of peace. Enable us to see everyone who crosses our path as our brother or sister. Make us sensitive to the plea of our citizens who entreat us to turn our weapons of war into implements of peace, our trepidation into confident trust, and our quarreling into forgiveness. All this we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. And we continue this morning with the general thanksgiving, followed by the prayer of St. Christopherson. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and for all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts, we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son, that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you, everyone, for joining this morning. Remember, we're here every morning at 8:30 at the Church of the Atonement in Chicago on Google Meet. Our Sunday services are 8, 9, and 11. The 11 o'clock service is broadcast on our YouTube channel. Thank you, everyone. Have a wonderful day and take care. Bye-bye.